Hallo und willkommen zurück zu Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. In der letzten Folge haben sich China und Byakuya feiner gekloppt. Dann ist ein Tag umgewiesen. Wir haben irgendwelche Leute gesucht zum Zeit verbringen, weil wir nur noch 7 Leute sind und für die Hälfte davon möchte nichts mehr mit uns machen. Oder sind Arschlöcher und wir wollen nichts mit denen machen. Und am nächsten Tag hat dann Genocide Jack China angegriffen. Jetzt kam Sakura rein. Ich habe am Ende der letzten Folge schon gesagt, man kann sich denken, wie das weitergeht. Und ich lasse es mal unkommentiert, ne? Sakura.
You heard. What happened?
Oh, nothing. It's not a big deal.
Makoto. Hero. What's the meaning of this?
It wasn't me. It was Genocide. It's all about that demented metal thing, so...
The Hardina. Damn you! Leave me alone! Brother! What is this? What is this?
I'm okay, really. It's just a scratch.
Nothing but a flesh wound.
No forgiveness! Unforgivable! I can't forgive them!
Wieso schreist du rum?
Hero, if you want to hate someone, hate me. If you want to hurt someone, hurt me.
I don't hate you, Mexico.
I can't. Why?
What is with me?
You were nearly tripped over himself as he ran screaming out of the nurse office. But just a second later. What's going on?
Hey. What's all this noise about?
Gyoko stood in the doorway of the nurse office, taking Hiro's spot in the room.
It would seem... I guess something happened.
Gyoko, please! You have to stop Sakura. Wait.
You don't need to stop me. I'm okay. I'm not going to do anything, I'm drawing a line right here and now.
Right here. Right now. Right here.
Drawing a line?
Goodbye.
Wait, Sakura!
You sprang into action, leaving the nurse office to chase after Sakura. The only ones left were... awkward.
Hi.
Hey, Kyoko! Kyoko? Are you still mad?
It's ein Ja. It's ein eindeutiges Ja.
Yeah, I figured.
That's fine.
It's fine.
Huh?
About that issue we discovered earlier, it doesn't matter anymore.
Then, do you forgive me for not being able to talk about it?
In other words...
You could have told me about Sakura and Monokuma fighting, but you stayed... Right. You were only thinking of Sakura, and that's why you didn't tell me, right? You didn't want to confuse everyone until you could talk to her and be sure of what you saw. That's what you were thinking, and that's why you didn't tell me, right?
Yeah, natürlich, ja, klar. Ich hätte auch sagen können, dass er sich gegen Monokuma auflehnt und damit irgendwie die Sache ein bisschen einfacher für uns zu machen, aber gut, ne?
To think like that,
I wouldn't have expected arrogance from you.
Danke, Kyoko. Ich hab jetzt kurzzeitig mich schon gewonnen.
I wouldn't have expected such arrogance from you.
What? It was Hadid Makoto!
Because
ultimately that means you don't trust me.
Eben!
No, that's not it.
Ja, wieso hast du es dir denn nicht erzählt, Mann? Ich vertraue Kyoko. Makoto wollte nicht.
Mr. Naegi.
Yeah.
But if that's how you feel, I can't really change your mind. I'm sorry.
That's fine.
It's fine. I already forgotten about it. Besides,
and
I may have overreacted.
Huh?
Anyway,
it's over and done with. Like I said, let's just forget about it.
Okay, thank you.
So. That issue we discussed doesn't matter anymore. I want to talk to you about something else.
Okay. What is it you want to talk to me about?
Indeed.
Actually, I'd like you to come somewhere with me. I have business there.
Where?
Just come with me and you'll find out. I guess, but...
Shall we go?
Then shall we get going? With her typical indifference, Yoko turned and walked away, setting a brisk pace.
Ah, Yoko! I hurried to catch up to her. She walked ahead in silence, and in silence I chased her, and then eventually we arrived. The dressing room? So, there's something else you mentioned?
Indeed.
That's right, it has to do with Alter Ego. But you said we didn't need Alter Ego anymore.
Wrong.
I didn't say we didn't need him, I just said he had done his job. Besides, it's not us that needs Alter Ego. Yes, business with us.
Huh?
Right.
Why did you ask me to bring others to come see him? Apparently he has something to, he wants to ask us. Alter Ego wants to ask us something?
Oh, schieß mal los, Alter Ego!
Hello. So it's just the two of you, Kyoko and Makoto?
Kyoko's finger glided across the keyboard. It's two not enough?
No, it's okay, two should be plenty.
But what is it he wants to ask us?
Indeed.
Let's find out, shall we?
Let's find out, shall we?
Welche Stimme? Das ist mein Mensch! Let's find out, shall we? Kyoko typed in the question. What did you want to ask us?
So... I'd like you to take me somewhere where you can connect me to the school network.
What?
What?
Yoko and I quickly glanced at each other. She replied, why?
You said my job was done, right? But to just stop here, saying I finished my work. I don't want that. I want to keep being helpful to everyone. I want to work as hard as everyone else, so that we can all get out of here. That's what Master would want too. So to help everyone else to solve the mystery of the school, the only way I can help is if you connect me to the school's network.
But if you did that, that's basically suicide. I'm positive the mastermind would find out about it. They find you and they... You agreed, right, Yoko?
No.
I realize how dangerous it could be, but still I have to do this.
But
I'm scared, but I can handle it. I don't really understand why, but
still.
When I think about everyone else, my courage starts to grow. You might think I'm just some inhuman AI, but it's true. So, it's cool. If it's for the sake of everyone else, I won't be afraid.
You couldn't help but get lost in that voice.
I was just so... It was just too committed. Too admirable. Too fragile.
Hey.
You remember what you asked before, Kodo? Just what the difference is between a person and a program, right?
Yeah.
Certainly.
We are talking to Alter Ego, I don't know. I have no idea how to answer that question. I think maybe that's a question even the program's creator can answer. But I can say this.
Correct.
There's no question that Alter Ego is our friend.
Yoko?
I...
To be honest, I didn't want Alter Ego to push himself anymore. Because if we take any more risks, the mastermind really will notice it. But...
Makoto.
Let's do it, Makoto. Let's connect Alter Ego to the network.
But,
hey.
He's our friend, so I want to take his feelings into consideration. And he says that he wants to fight alongside his friends.
Now,
if you were in his place, would you just sit by and do nothing in this situation? If you saw everyone else fighting and doing their best, would you just look the other way? Or would you stand up? Stand up tall next to everyone else and tell them, you're their friend.
So,
are you guys fighting? If it's about me, please don't.
I wanna believe in myself.
You go, Alter Ego. You go.
I want to be able to say, I know I can do this.
Leave it to me.
So please, let me try.
listen.
And besides, there's one place that Radamus might not notice. One place?
That's right.
Remember, there's another place besides here where there's no surveillance camera. A room without a surveillance camera. That's it, the secret room you're telling me about. I definitely remember there was no surveillance camera in there. And I do believe you can connect to the network from there. I remember seeing an inner part on the wall.
However,
it's just because there's no camera that doesn't mean there's no danger. There's no way to be sure that Mesmin isn't monitoring the network somehow. Let's have to move Alter Ego. The Mesmin may spot us going into the secret room. If you pick up any of this, then it's all over. You're right.
That's what we have to do.
But despite all that, there's still a thing we need to try.
Correct.
Because that's our best chance of finding any new clues. Yeah, good. You will? In that case, you let me carry him. There's no way you could hide him with what you're wearing, right? So let me do it.
It's true.
Okay then, I'll leave you. I'll leave it to you. Thank you.
So then.
Let's get started. Gonna be a little cramp for you, Alter Ego. Bear with us, okay? We started packing up. We're packing him up right away. I closed the laptop and stuffed it underneath my jacket.
It tickles.
Shh! You can't talk right now.
Alter Ego, Ashtai, we're going to move you to another room. Until we get there, you have to be absolutely silent, okay?
Understood. Your command has been implemented.
Good.
Wenn ich mit ihm spreche, dann hätten wir ganz. Egal. Ich überleg zu viel. I have him react like a machine like that all of a sudden. I don't know how to react.
Makoto.
In that secret room, there's a bunch of different cables. I don't know if the desk was. There might be a network cable in there?
However.
Assuming the mastermind hasn't taken it already? Well. All we can do is go and check for ourselves.
It's true.
Agreed. Let's head to the secret room. Van Malos. Gibt nichts Mysteriöses hier zu sehen. Alles wie gewohnt. Lalala, hallo. Oh.
Hey, Makoto.
What?
Are you sure all the documents are gone? I just believe you.
Go and check again.
What?
Listen to me.
Just hurry up and go. And to make sure you don't run off, run away right here. Oh, I get it. She's acting. She was so forceful. I thought I made her mad again somehow.
Just a second.
Why are you just standing there? Hurry up and go!
Okay, I'm going.
So then.
I'll be thorough. I'm counting on you. The Malons. No, honestly, I just. Okay, first we have to find that network cable. In the drawers, it's gesagt. According to Kyoko, there should be a bunch of cables in this drawer. I found it. There's a network cable, right? Now we just have to connect Alter Ego. Immediately, I got to work. I pulled out the laptop and connected it to the Ethernet port with the cable. And that should do it.
Yeah, I think it worked.
Leave it to me.
Just leave the rest to me. I swear I'll find something. I might even be able to connect to the outside world. Okay, I'll see if I can call for help.
So
please, just wait a little while longer. Just hold tight and put your faith in me.
As I was about to leave, I decided to leave him with one last thing. No matter what, we're gonna get out of here. You and all the rest of us as friends.
Huh?
Friends? Even me?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Makoto.
Gut, ja, dann gehen wir mal wieder. Gut, go. Ja, ist alles weg, ne? But okay, but all the documents were gone, just like I told you.
The player was an unintentional mix of acting and real feelings.
Correct.
I see. And there's nothing left for us here.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. A final message. Change the world. Goodbye. Before I knew it, Kyoko was walking away and she wasn't acting anymore. That much was for sure. Kyoko?
What?
Yes. So we're just gonna split up.
Why is that?
Of course, I have no reason to stay with you at this point. Well, maybe, but isn't that a little too direct? Should I hesitate and fumble for something to say? You're so high maintenance. Well, that's not what I meant. I just had more I wanted to talk to you about. Like, what are you going to do about Sakura?
It's true.
Something has to be done. It's true. But the way things are right now, there's no way to pursue anyone. We don't have the mind to listen. Then what should we?
So...
if we can find some new clue, that would likely change the situation. That's all we can hope for right now. Which is why, alter ego.
Correct.
All we can do is wait and believe in our friends. You're right, that's our only option. Oh god, this is unsere unser Marsch. We parted ways and I headed back to my room. Ja, das ist ja mal ein schöner Haufen Mist. I'm kinda tired. So I lay down in bed. Maybe it was because of the stress of moving. Alter ego, but I was way more tired than I realized. So before long at all. Oh, angepennt. I had completely dozed off. Ding dong! Mein Wecker ist da! Oh. Ja, ich komm doch. The sharp sound of the doorbell pierced my sleep haze and pulled me back to the real world. Komm doch schon.
Makoto.
Get out here. Yoko, what's going on? Yuna just came to see me and she was white as a ghost. It sounds like something's happened. What? As soon as I heard those words, my heart started to beat a little faster. I suddenly found myself wide awake. He said for us to come to the rec room. The rec room? Okay, let's hurry up. Oh, the rec room. The rec room. Hello, Hina.
Oh, God, Kyoko.
Hina, what's wrong?
So, something is not right. In the rec room.
What's inside?
There was a window. Window. On the rec room door. I heard to look inside.
And when I did, falsche Stimme. Sakura. Is she unconscious? Is she sitting up in a chair but like she's bowing her head?
Hey.
What's going on? Did something happen to her?
Huh?
I was just walking past and I happened to notice her through the window. But I couldn't get the door open. I tried knocking, I tried calling her name, but she wouldn't respond.
Huh?
So what should we do? What are we gonna do?
Anyway...
first of all, we need to get into that room. But the door's locked, right? If we break in, we'll be violating school regulations. We're going to fuss our way in. I just said the door isn't locked. It's not locked because the rec room doesn't have the lock. Then why? It feels like the door is pressing up against something inside the room. Is it the chair? The chair?
In other words.
Either way, this door isn't locked, which means, as far as I can tell, the rule doesn't apply. Then there's no problem if we break in?
Indeed.
Let's smash the window. That should be the fastest way.
Okay, I'll go get something to break it with. Wait right here.
Inside the rec room, Sakura still hadn't moved an inch. She's just unconscious, right? Nein, sie ist tot. Is she okay? I mean, it's Sakura, I'm sure. Kyoko didn't reply. There was only silence, but that silence didn't last long.
Here! I found a broom! In the classroom! Here is it!
Makoto.
You can handle this, right, Makoto?
Oh.
Come on, please, hurry!
Okay, you two stand back. I took hold of the broom and swung as hard as I can, aiming directly at the window. All it took was one solid hit. The window shattered into 100 pieces scattering across the rec room floor. I stuck my hand through the window, through the now open window, and started jostling the chair leaning against the door.
chair is pretty heavy, but if I can just push it, I push on it with all my strength and finally the knob turned. Sakura! I went up to her as fast as I could. But the moment I laid my hand on her, all I felt was cold death. I could feel only the last lingering warmth of a living body. Life had abandoned Sakura's body. And then... Ich hatte recht. Wüsste, seitdem Monokuma gesagt hat, dass sie der Spion ist, dass sie die nächste Person sein wird, die sterben wird. Ja, der Class Drop beginnt. Ja, ja, das kennen wir ja schon. Deadly Life! Deadly Life! Sakura's.
Sakura's dead?
Ja, 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 so kann man es ausdrücken.
She's really dead?
Oh! Alright, Tina talking, but my eyes stared steadily forward. I could only look on as Sakura's dead body. We didn't make it in time. It's happened again. Muttering to herself, Yoko began gently to inspect Sakura's body. I wondered, was she confirming that Sakura really was dead, checking for a pulse or a reaction? I have to go get them. I have to go get the others. And Shaky Leg Sina left the rec room. And I... Why did this have to happen? That's all I could say. I repeated it over and over again. I need to examine Sakura's body. I just stood there motionless behind her while she checked Sakura's corpse. Time passed. When I stood there, unable to do a thing, time just passed. And after... I don't know how long... I get everyone. Oh, guru.
Oh, she's... So she's there, huh?
Sakura's been killed. I see. As soon as they arrived, Kyoko began.
Just a second.
Yeah, the announcement just arrived. So you know what this means. Sakura was murdered by someone in this very room. Is that what you were going to say?
No. Whoever killed her. It's not just someone in this room. It was one of you, Hiro, Byakuya, Toko, one of your kids, Sakura.
What? You're accusing us before we even begun the investigation?
I don't need to investigate anything, because you hated her. You hated the sight of her. One of you did it. I know it.
You know it?
Jeez, I didn't know your power level would increase by that much just by getting mad. What are you doing here? Isn't it obvious? I'm here to hand out my little mother flyer. That's right, it's the next Monokuma file. And don't get so mad, Miss Asahina. Oh, are you gonna ruin that little fetus of yours? Not then, with that eye.
Hold on. There's something I want to ask you. It was you, wasn't it? You killed Sakura. Sakura wanted to change the mastermind to a duel. Maybe you and her fought again, and then...
Did I kill her? Sorry, not quite. Actually, not even close. The whole thing is totally irrelevant now. Sakura came, the most regrettable, and without even getting the chance to finish things with me. Which, thank God for that, it saved me the trouble of having to go through with our little fight. Cause even for someone like me, it would have been no mean feat to take down a behemoth like that. I gotta tell you, it was actually pretty worried. I mean, she violated a rule by attacking me in the first place, but I wasn't able to punish her. Seid ihr noch etwas?
But whoever the black one is this time,
are you one?
What is this?
Yeah, what the hell? Oopsie! Before you get all busybody at me, you better figure out who did it first. Cause I mean, your life's all on the line, right?
What is this?
What the hell? He asked him one. I hate him. I hate this whole thing.
Well, I for one am glad it was Sakura. She was working for the mastermind after all.
How can you say that now?
Sorry, I don't have time for your scrabbling. Next game has already begun. If you want to be angry at someone, be angry at whoever killed Sakura.
Anyway.
Right now, our top priority needs to be uncovering Sakura's killer. If you can do that, we're all dead.
Then let's decide who will stand guard this time.
I'll do it.
You know?
I'm okay. Just let me handle it. Besides, I want to be here with Sakura.
That's fine.
Okay, then it's guard number one. Well, we need one more. Yoko, that's you.
What?
Me?
Okay, be like your boss.
You're always a thorn in my side this time. Just stand by and watch quietly. Consider that an order.
An order?
That's fine.
Fine, I stay behind.
Then it's settled. Let's begin, shall we?
Hold on. Before that, there's something I want to say.
What? Just?
Hiro, Byakuya, Toko, none of you are allowed to step foot in the crime scene.
What? What?
What have you killed, Sakura? I won't let someone like that come anywhere near you.
Don't be stupid, our lives are in just as much danger as yours. We have every right to investigate.
I don't care what you say. I'm not letting the one who killed Sakura anywhere near you. Even if it means I have to use force, you're not getting it out.
Well, it appears further discussion would be a waste of time. How about a compromise?
It's all clear now.
I won't ask you to let us all of us in, just let me.
What?
I don't really care, do you? You're both useless anyway.
Yep.
Don't really care. I'd rather spend my time coming up with another splendid fantasy weapon master anyway.
And you, Hiro? Do you really object? You're gonna go that far, what can I do? I mean, I don't have anything to hide, so why should I care?
It's all clear now.
Then it's decided.
What are you saying?
Nothing's decided!
Calm down.
I know how you feel, Hiro, but you should agree to this request.
But...
Hey.
You have to find out who killed Sakura.
Correct.
But those of us still alive, and to honor Sakura's memory.
Fine, I guess that's okay. But no matter what, Byakuya, you absolutely aren't allowed to touch her.
Literally, who would want to touch a foot in that body?
Listen.
It's enough fighting. We need to focus on the investigation from here on out. Everyone, keep this in mind. If we can uncover Sakura's killer, all of us face execution.
Finding out who killed Sakura, it's not a matter of hoping we can do it. If we want to survive, we have to do it. It's kind of hopeless hope. We have no choice but to just do it.
Byakuya is there, suspect. I better check the monocomb before anything else. The victim was Sakura Ogami. The time of death was estimated around 12 noon. While he was discovered in the rec room on the third floor of the school. There was evidence of a strong blow to the victim's head. No other injuries were noted. However, it seems that at some point the victim suffered from violent vomiting of blood. Poisoning!
Hey.
I think the case this time might be a challenge. Why is that?
So...
The only way into the rec room is the door we just came through. And that door had been jammed shut with the chair from... Side rec room.
which means the killer would have had to escape somehow after banging the door. So if the door was blocked from the inside, there was no way in or out till we broke the window. There's like zero escape,
right?
In other words, this is a classic locked room murder.
Locked room murder? I guess you might see this kind of thing a lot in mystery movies, books, or whatever. But could it really happen in real life? And right before very eyes like this?
I'm curious to hear more about what a locked room murder entails. Sure, if you don't mind. You break down this kind of murder mystery, there are four basic types. The first type is when the locked room is cleared after the actual crime is committed. This simply means that a killer commits this crime then through some special method seals the room. This may involve some sort of trick involving the lock of the door. This trick approaches include using a device. So for that...
My god, ich hab... ja...
Grundsätzlich angeben, Kyogo. So for that we all have to do is check the door to see if that's what it was, right? The second type is when the locked room already exists before the crime was committed. Oh. In other words. Basically the killer. Ja. Ich weiß, worauf du uns hinweisen möchtest. Das ist schön und gut. You pass the space and find some honey gun and you shoot arrow for the gabble and blow and something like that. However. In this game, that doesn't seem to fit. There's no comments on Amazon that's going in the I think we can probably cross that off.
It's true.
The third ich weiß! Oh, ey!
In other words.
Yes, they're hidden when the door is open, they use the confusion to blend English to jump. The window is shut up along with everyone else, and it's not. There's something that could have been possible, maybe.
It's true.
The fourth and final type is when it wasn't actually locked room at all. As an occur, but that means you're searching out an escape route somewhere in the room. Then there's a lot of numbers and things that are in the room. You're thinking of conquering somewhere in the room, too? Nobody says yes. So when it comes to another mystery, there's something wrong. But there's a 4% bias. Standing here, we should have those four chances to be in the stack in this case. That's a good question, answering that should be our primary focus on this. But right now, I can't really see. I see.
Das hat uns jetzt überhaupt nicht weitergeholfen! Ey! Komm, willst du uns doch noch erklären, was ein toter Körper ist? Wie man eine Person umbringt? Welche Möglichkeiten es dort geben würde? Und die erste ist mit einer Waffe. Die zweite ist, jemanden zu erschlagen. Die dritte ist, jemanden zu erwürgen.
The way the killer set up the locked room until I figured it out, the truth behind Sigurd's death will stay hidden. It's definitely a tough mystery. I need to concentrate and investigate as much as I can. Sigurd, if nothing else. Okay. Okay, interessanter Raum. Ich bedanke mich fürs Zusehen, sage tschüss, bis zum nächsten Mal und auf Wiedersehen.